home of beauty, art, culture, and legendary food. Our time in Bakeation begins in a magical place, where the roads are made of water.
Nel blu, dipinto di blu.
And you can't take a motorbike on water, so we've taken a boat.
Mate, we're finally here! Venice, the floating jewel in Italy's crown!
Well, simply put, Venice is the most beautiful city on the planet! But it's dead weird because we've had to abandon the motorbikes outside the city walls. From now on, it's all walking and water!
What more can you ask for?
But it's weird because for weeks now we've been in Northern Europe. Now we're entering Southern Europe. There's a change of climate, a change of pace, a change of life. It hits you like a ton of bricks, doesn't it?
Oh, it's fabulous, mate.
This is going to be a wonderful trip. Oh, by the way. Buono. Piazza San Marco, por favore.
Va bene.
Sì, grazie.
This is more like it, dude. There's barely a soul around.
This is the real Venice. It's where real people live.
I mean, look at this. This is virtually peak holiday season and there's hardly anybody on the streets.
Perfect. And I bet that somewhere around here we'll find the ideal place for our first Italian cook.
We're doing focaccia, a classic Italian bread. And the great thing about focaccia is that it's the least amount of work
for the most amount of pleasure. What a treat. This is the real Venice. And actually, we're cheating a bit because focaccia is not a Venetian dish.
No.
It's from Liguria.
It is, but wouldn't you know that?
Yeah, I mean, after all, you don't have to go to Hamburg to make a hamburger, do you?
No, you don't, mate.
You don't!
No, there's lots of them everywhere.
Listen. Everybody whistles in Venice, don't they?
Shall we get cooking?
We shall. This is the real easy focaccia. This is...
Yeah, don't sing the cornetto thing.
Step uno, add a sachet of yeast.
It doesn't have to be the German one, but we had some left over.
To a bowl of plain flour. Next, a teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of sugar to activate the yeast.
But you know all that, it's basic dough. The secret of focaccia dough
is olive oil. Pour 2 tablespoons into warm water.
The weapon of choice?
Thank you. Add to the dry goods and mix.
It's a noisy spot, isn't it? They're all work boats.
So now it's time to get your hands in it. Once it's formed a nice ball of dough, what we're going to do is knock 7 bells of Venice out of it.
Yes.
And what that does, it smooths the dough out, but it also activates the gluten in the flour.
And the activated gluten makes it bouncy bread. So let's activate our lean, mean, Geordie kneading machine.
Crack on, old love.
Go on, mate.
And remember, when you bake bread, the softer the dough, the better the bread.
And you really want to knead like this for about a good 5 minutes.
Once kneaded, cover with cling film and leave to rise in a warm place. Venice, who will do next?
Oh. Go for a whistle.
I might as well.
Behold, look at that.
Oi. Passes the oil, mate. Oil a shallow baking tray.
And using your knuckles, spread the dough to fill it.
Kingy.
What, mate?
Is this not one of the best things you've ever done? Standing in Venice making focaccia.
It's fantastic. I love Italy.
Italian is a new solo, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
What's your dream?
My dream is to have a citrus garden and an olive grove. And I want to sit with my grandchildren, sucking oranges. That's what I want to do. That's it. Very simple.
Yes.
Just getting there is killing us.
Well, my dream's getting this focaccia finished and getting it down me.
Was I getting carried away?
The dough needs another rest, so we'll pop it under our Baroque Venetian bureau and leave it for half an hour. And since this is a bake which lends itself to sightseeing,
time for a little wander.
You know what, Si? Italian cooking is so regional that some would say our focaccia has no place in Venice.
They are a little parochial, dude, but let's face it, Italian food's gone global.
Yeah, it belongs to the world now. We're coming,
bringing it home. And what finer place to bring it home than to this gorgeous city?
And it looks as if our whistling workman's off home too.
Joe!
Good. Means we can actually concentrate on the bread.
Look at this little lovely...
Beautiful.
Oh, marvellous.
Now, focaccia isn't focaccia without rosemary. So chop up 2 tablespoons of rosemary leaves very finely.
Then get stuck into the dough with the famous two-finger stab.
All those holes, they're going to hold the oil, salt and rosemary bits. Look at that.
Isn't that nice?
Black pepper. And sea salt flakes. I love this because the sea salt, it's just like crystals on the top.
Beautiful.
You need about 3 tablespoons of olive oil, but basically, just slosh it on. So a few sprigs of rosemary in the top, like so. All we need to do now is to pop this into a preheated oven, a hot one, about 200 to 220 degrees Celsius, about 20 minutes till it's golden crispy.
Well, we could, if we had an oven. You see, because in Italy, you can't cook in a public space with a gas cylinder and said oven. Because otherwise you get into loads of bother. So, yeah,
you've got to have a fire officer there to ensure that 2 leery northerners don't actually burn down the city. So therefore, we need to find a nearby hostelry who'll avail of the hospitality of their oven.
Yes, in the absence of a fire safety officer.
And the ammo.
That way, over the bridge.
To your preheated oven is shorter than ours.
Buongiorno.
This really is one of the most simple and simply satisfying bread recipes we've cooked so far.
Ciao.
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 And it only needs 20 minutes in a hot oven.
Right. Ah, oh, perfetto, grazie.
That'll give us just time to have a little espresso by the canal side.
Oh, yes.
Heaven. Romantic Venice, isn't it? You know, pity we're like with each other.
Get off.
Ah, come on, Kingy. Italian is the language of love. Amore. Maybe learning a few phrases will help.
Cosa?
Di cosa?
Si.
Si.
Occupa.
Occupa. The toilet is occupied. What? My focaccia is about to catch fire.
Good point, dude. Good point.
Look at that, mate. You cannot whack that, can you?
Oh, it looks so. It's just quite a catalogue. That is proper, super delish focaccia.
Happy Venetian holidays.
Not half.
Oh, hey. Man, that's mega.
It's the easiest thing in the world to make.
And the texture, well, the olive oil in the mix, superb.
And one of the good things about focaccia is because of the oil, wrap this in foil when it's cold and it's going to last for about a week. And then for your breakfast, just take a slice off, split it, fill it with your filling of choice, and every time you take a bite, you're going to be back in Venice.